Hey, you know what's awesome? The first two Dio albums. A big part of why those albums are so awesome is the guitar playing. Let's talk about Vivian Campbell. Welcome to my studio. I'm Angus Clark. I hope you're doing well. One of the first concerts I ever attended was Black Sabbath's Mob Rules Tour in May of 1982. I love that record, and getting to see Ronnie James Dio front that band was amazing. I was a diehard Sabbath fan, and it broke my heart that they didn't carry on with Ronnie. But word got around that Dio was working on something of his own, and then one day on MTV, there it was. The first single from the first Dio album featuring Vivian Campbell on guitar. The video featured Ronnie shouting at clouds from a rooftop in London, and the solo was an absolute masterpiece. It was Rainbow in the Dark. I bought the Holy Diver album as soon as it came out. It had a much more raw sound than Mob Rules did, which made it edgier, and I was an immediate fan of the whole thing. I was particularly a fan of Vivian Campbell, whose playing on the Holy Diver album is off the hook. If you've seen the recent Dio documentary or you're a fan of Dio's, I'm sure you know the story. Viv, young Irish guitar player brought in by former Rainbow bassist Jimmy Bain. Viv goes, he nails the audition, then he's flown to LA, and they make the record at Sound City Studios, legendary Sound City Studios. So Dio had this knack for writing epics, like, and there was always room for this big guitar solo section. And it was like a song within a song. And a great example of that kind of thing is on the title track, Holy Diver. Being from Ireland, Viv was a big fan of Rory Gallagher and Gary Moore, and both those guys have a really aggressive right-hand technique and proper rock and roll chops. But Viv, like Gary, had this expanded technical capacity that kept up with the onset of 80s shred, while still having the rock and roll swagger and tone. Viv played a Les Paul Deluxe that he had converted with full-size humbuckers into a Marshall with a Boss Overdrive. There's some question about which pickups were actually in the guitar when he made the record, but he was definitely using DiMarzio X2Ns during the Holy Diver tour. Now, I went to see Dio on that tour at the Beacon Theater in New York in October of 1983. It was amazing to me that I was seeing the same guy I had seen at Madison Square Garden just 18 months earlier at this relatively small theater right down the street from where I lived. It was totally awesome. One of my favorite solos they played it that night is what Viv plays in Don't Talk to Strangers. We'll be right back. I love that solo. That song wraps itself around the solo really well. And Viv's tone is super cool. There's something like filtered on the pick attack. I just love the way it sounds. So he also has this muted picking thing that he does on the two-string arpeggio licks. That's just a total ripper. I love that one. It's the end of the first side, back when albums had sides. Anyway, Holy Diver is a great album. Pretty much every solo on there is a complete ripper. Now, they followed Holy Diver up with the album Last in Line, which also has some stellar moments, but the standout to me is the title cut, Last in Line. That solo is so well composed. And again, the song wraps around the solo in a way that makes it all the more epic. I saw Dio at the Meadowlands Arena on the Last in Line tour, which was awesome because it was like watching him claw his way back to the arena stage after having to start over again as a solo artist. And Viv's time with Dio lasted for only one more album, Sacred Heart, which has its moments but doesn't really stand up as well as the first two, and that's an opinion that I think most of that band agrees on. I saw that tour in LA with Viv on guitar, and then I saw it again in New York to see his replacement, Craig Goldie. So Viv has crushed it on a lot of different stuff since then. The River Dogs album, definitely check out the River Dogs album. It has great playing on it. He made a solo album of his own where he sings and plays guitar. He joined the reformed Thin Lizzy for some tour dates. If you can catch the footage of that, it is awesome. And of course, all of his work with Def Leppard is amazing. Lately, he's been letting it rip most prominently with his band Last in Line. Now, I've only met Viv twice. Once way back when I was in college, I went to NAMM and I met him there. It was probably right before he joined Whitesnake, and he was super cool. It was really inspiring to me. And then I met him again at a Last in Line show at a local club here in New Jersey in 2019. And again, super friendly. We're just talking about gear, and that was awesome. If you get a chance to go see that band, you should definitely go. Viv is absolutely kicking ass, and it is just a joy to watch him vibing with Vinny, and the whole band is great. And he is still playing the Black Les Paul from the Holy Diver album. Speaking of which, you may have noticed my guitar. Yeah, I had that done up by my repair guy because I just needed a guitar like that. It was just so inspiring to me, so iconic. It's actually a recent Gibson 50s standard with the top taken off and done in flat black, just like Viv had his done. And it's got really high output pickups from Pariah, which are awesome pickups. Anyway, that's it for me. Thank you for watching. And here's to you, Viv. Thank you for all the music. I will leave you with my performance of a solo I composed for a Ronnie James Dio song called This Is Your Life. We did a full band arrangement using an isolated vocal track. I did it with some friends. We think it came out great. And I really tried to pay homage to Viv with my choices in this solo. And I hope I did a good job. Take care.